In this video, we will show you how to use the Gocator Emulator to estimate the max frame rate you can expect for an application. Gocator sensors are designed to gather data as fast as possible. Select sensors from our G2 line can reach max scan rates of up to 10 kHz. However, reaching these speeds depends on a number of factors, such as scan area, exposure time, and tools. To download the emulator, find it on our website at lmi3d.com under the Support tab. The emulator comes preloaded with a series of scans made with different sensor models. You can check what sensor model is being emulated by looking at the model column. Once you have a sample GS file loaded, uncheck replay protection so that we can start changing sensor settings. All of the adjustments we will be making are located in the Scan tab. Measurements and tools can be run in sensor, but they also can be accelerated by an external computer or GoMax. The frame rate of the sensor, however, cannot be externally accelerated. You will have to choose a sensor model that gives you the cycle speed you need. Keep in mind that the maximum frame rate number is a best case calculation from the key acquisition settings. The final sustainable speed can only be determined once the sensor is actually scanning. That being said, experimenting in the emulator can be helpful to get a sense of which sensors would be best for your application and what general speeds to expect. One of the largest contributing factors to sensor speed is the scan area. By clicking select, we can crop the sensor's field of view, capturing just the area that we are interested in. For example, if we know the height of our inspected object, we can crop out the rest of the vertical space as it is not being used. One thing to keep in mind is that the area of the field of view closest to the sensor, the near field, will have the most data points. This means that you will get a higher resolution scan if your part is closer to the sensor. It also means that your maximum speed will go down if your object or surface is closer to the sensor. All of this to say that maximum speed will be achieved by cropping to the lower portion of the scan area. If you are experimenting with the scan area and don't see any changes in maximum frame rate, you might be exposure limited. Exposure, seen here, is the amount of time the sensor's camera is exposed to the laser light. Depending on the surface of the object you are scanning, your exposure time might be the limiting factor for maximum speed. For example, if your exposure time is set to 1000 microseconds, no matter how small your active area is, you will not be able to have a frame rate over 1 kHz. This is why some applications can benefit from more powerful lasers. The stronger the laser, the shorter the needed exposure time, allowing for a faster cycle speed. Using multiple exposures also reduces the speed. Each additional exposure contributes time to creating a frame. Subsampling is another way to increase sensor speed. By clicking 1/2 for Z resolution, we are effectively binning every other data point along the Z axis. This can also be done for X resolution. If maximum resolution is not necessary for the application, subsampling is an easy way to dramatically increase sensor speed. By experimenting with these settings and more, the emulator becomes a useful tool for figuring out which sensors will keep up with the speed requirements you have for your application. If you have any questions about this, feel free to reach out to us using the contact page at lmi3d.com.